Good morning, guys. It's a beautiful Sunday morning today. First of all, I want to appreciate you guys for, hanging there and tolerating the NodeJS class. And I also have a couple of apologies to run by you. I'm really sorry for how the class has been going through the weeks. We actually planned some classes, but over the weeks some Node.js mentors got really busy, and it's one of those things, because as developers, which you guys will soon start, most of you actually, because some of you are already professional developers, I don't know what you are doing here, but as developers we get jobs and we get gigs, so our life is not pre-planned. We actually plan for things and it doesn't turn up the way we planned. So we get jobs, we get gigs, and we get busy. So it's part of life, it's part of what happens. So yeah, over the week, some Node.js mentors got really busy, including myself, because if you've noticed, I haven't really been quite active with the class as I was when we initially. So I got busy over the week, really busy. Even as I speak with you, I have something planned. I haven't finished, but nevertheless, the class must go on and you guys must learn. So I want to appreciate your efforts, which you've put in to learning Node.js. I assure you that it won't, no matter how this class goes, learning Node.js is not something you will regret over time. You'll actually come to realize that it's one of the best investments in your life that you've ever done. So yeah, thumbs up to you guys. Some of you have already started learning on your own, visiting YouTube. I appreciate you. What's your name? Gopi, I don't know if I pronounced that right. So Gopi builds an app by himself without us even teaching him. So this is like the kind of things I encourage from you guys. You don't have to wait for your mentors to teach you stuff. So you can go to YouTube, search up some videos, anything you don't understand, do your research. It's part of the developer life. Most of the things we learned, nobody had to teach us. I learned Node.js on my own. I started out as a front-end developer, decided that, I can't just remain as a front-end developer. I wanted to learn more, and I started learning Node.js by myself. Then I learned C# also. So you guys should, be proactive, go to YouTube, Google stuff, read the Node.js docs if you can, read some articles on your own, and then build projects, build little projects by yourself. Like this guy here built a movie project, I think so, which is really impressive. So do these things, upload it to GitHub, and post your code to GitHub, write articles about what you've learned, and then create awareness for yourself, which is something I never ever did while I was starting out, because I'm kind of a low-key guy, so I never really liked attention to myself. So I just built stuff, and then just my own little corner, I didn't showcase it. But you guys don't have to do it the way I did it. You can build stuff and then post to GitHub, and then go to Twitter. If you have a Twitter account, go to Twitter and showcase what you built, and get the likes, get the reviews, get the retweets, and who knows, you can even actually get a job from doing that. So yeah, so for this class, I would like to go over the last task, because someone asked me to explain what streams are, streams and buffer, and I would like to explain that in the context of the last task, because one of the aims of the last task was to, you know, to ensure you understood file system and streams and buffers are something that we use in files, in NodeJS file systems. So yeah, I would be pulling up something from right, so that's coming up. You guys should forgive me, my system has been acting up lately. But we'll have to wait for this to load up. Yep. Alright guys, so to explain what streams buffers really is, I usually like to, you know, do it with the layman view, the layman team, so that you can better understand what these things are, what these concepts are. So imagine this, look at this picture now. Description here, it's called NodeJS Candy Mountain. So imagine these were candies, or imagine these were rocks. Okay, let's call them rocks. Imagine they were rocks. How would you transfer or transport these rocks from this forest to probably your house where you live? Probably you wanted to create a bridge, or you wanted to create a bridge from your house to over the river, and you needed rocks. So how would you transport these rocks to that location? So one very smart way to do it would be, you know, take these rocks one by one. So you take this particular one, you put it inside a truck, a very heavy truck that can carry it. Excuse me. So you put it over, when you put it into a very heavy truck that can carry this rock, you go back, you take this particular rock, you put it into that heavy truck until the truck is full, and then you transport it to your location. So that's basically what buffers and stream are. So they are basically, so I have buffers are temporary storage spots for chunk of data that is being transferred from one place to the other. So like I said here, so these are chunks, these are data chunks. I call them rocks. So I wanted to transport this rock to my house. So to do that, I went over to the forest, picked a rock, put it into the truck. The truck is the buffer. So it stores up these rocks one by one, stores them up, and then transports them over, and then I enter my truck, transport them over to my house. You guys understand? So yeah, so to transfer from one place to the other, the buffer is filled with data then passed along. So like I said, I fill up my buffer with this data here, and then I transport. So it transfers small chunks of data at a time. So this diagram here shows a better explanation of what I was trying to say. So you have your data, so your large chunk of data. So you transport that data one by one into a buffer. So look at your buffer here. You can see that it's filling up the data one by one, one by one, one by one. So it finally gets filled up, and then it's passed on to wherever you want to use it. So that's buffer. So streams, what are streams? Streams are just your paths. The paths through which this data is being transferred. So you had, like I said, you have your data. So through, this is the path here through which the data is being transferred, and that's what is known as stream. So data being passed down to the buffer in small chunks, the buffer gets filled up, and then it's passed down as a full data, smaller chunks of data, to wherever it's going to be used. So the whole process is known as stream. So some of you guys watch YouTube videos, you watch Netflix. So this is basically the process that Netflix uses. Netflix and YouTube, this is the process they use. So you've been heard of buffering, the video is buffering. So Netflix, if a video gets uploaded into Netflix database, they don't just send that movie data straight to the client. You know, they pass it through a process which allows that data to get streamed. So it's the data gets streamed by through little buffers, which then loads up on your browser. So if you have a very good internet, you'll see that on the timeline for your video, you see how that video gets streamed through little buffers. Let me see if I can open a YouTube video to show you that. So YouTube. All right, so let's play this one. I'm going to mute because I don't want the sound. It's going to play an ad first, so that's all right. Am I connected to the net? Yeah. So you can see, look at how it's buffering. These are buffers through which your data is being passed on. So it didn't just send in the data straight up to you. You can see how it's doing. It's sending it by through small chunks of data, because doing it that way will require a whole lot more time to load up, and a whole lot, and it's going to be slower, and it's going to be memory consuming. So they programmed it in such a way through which your data loads up and then it streams to you. So that's what I was trying to explain to you. So it's the same process. It's the same process that happens with Node.js and buffers and streams. For pipes, I'll come back to this later. Let me demonstrate what I mean. So if you can see my code here, I've written some codes to explain what streams are. So so with our HTTP, I declared an HTTP variable. Then look here, I created a data stream variable. So you have a data stream that collects data, or an object creates read stream from the file system variable. And what does that do? This create read stream just passes in the paths. Let me remove this because I want to show you something. So it passes in the paths. Ignore this for now. And then I use my variable to check for the data. So I say on data, this is an event. I don't know if you've learned about events before. If you haven't, maybe if I have the time, I could explain that to you in another video. But I pass in a data event which checks for the chunk, the data chunk, through a callback. So I've explained callback to you. Callbacks are functions that are inside a function. So this on is a function, and then you have callback. A callback which takes an argument called chunk. So now I can decide to do whatever I want with this chunk. For now, I'm just going to console log this chunk here. And let's see what we're going to get in our console. Let me clear up my console. By the way, guys, if you are still wondering how I got my terminal in my Node.js, it's just simple Control J. So J for Jesus. So hold down your Control key and press down the J key. So Control J. So what am I going to say here? I'm going to save my file first. Okay, sorry guys, you might have noticed a time lapse or lapsing my recording. That was because I had recorded the full video and, you know, coming over to this app, I figured out that I had stopped recording. I don't know, the app just stops recording my video, so I had to record again. So yeah, in the last section, I stopped at, you know, trying to console log this chunk gotten from our create write stream. So or our create read stream, sorry. So I've initially I explained this part, but unfortunately my recording stops. So yeah. I was saying that this is another way you can pass in a path. I usually go for this. So you can see the difference here. I've explained this in a previous class before. This is called concatenating. So I'm concatenating a variable to a string. So this is one way to do it. But another way to do it would be, or usually the old way or the normal way to do it would be with this format. So concatenate with your plus and then your variable. So whichever way you choose to do it, it's fine. I would usually go for this way. So yeah, so I said let's console log the chunk and see what we'll get. So save this file. Alright, so I think I figured out why my recording keeps stopping. I'm still trying to get used to this OBS studio, but nevertheless. Alright, so I just console logged the chunk right now and I saved my file. And this is what I got in my console. So you can see this is one chunk here. This is another chunk here. Another chunk here. And another chunk here, so four chunks of buffers or four chunks of data that is being buffered through that stream. So new chunk received was from here. I'm just console logging this text and then I'm console logging my chunk. So yeah, that's for create read stream. Another file system function is writing the stream, so create write stream. So I told you that you can do whatever you want with this chunk. We can decide to write that chunk to a file. So over here, by the way guys, I'm commenting and uncommenting my code with Ctrl+/. So Ctrl+/ on VS Code or whatever code editor you choose to use. CTL Ctrl+this. So that's just a hotkey to comment your code. Yeah, so create read write stream. So now let's write this stream to a data or to a file. So now create write stream and then I'm passing in the paths. This is what I'm going to call the file here, write.txt. You know, comment this. So I'm using my create write stream variable and then I'm writing the stream. So data write stream dot write. This write takes in the chunk that I'm passing down here. So I told you you can do whatever you want with that chunk data. Now I've decided to write the data over here. So let's save this. Let me check if I'm still recording. I am. Yeah, so create this, save this, and then... Oh, by the way, I haven't explained something yet. You can see, you can notice here that the buffer or the data that was being passed or that was being shown on our console is not really readable. That's because we've not passed in an argument called the encoding, so the character encoding. So the character encoding for this will be UTF-8. So let's save this and then let's read that data, that data in that stream. Check if I'm still recording. I am. All right, so you can see what it's doing. It's writing or it's reading my data from here. Data I got, the data that I pass in through this file. That's my JSON data of airports codes or airlines. So it's reading it and then it's displaying it on the console. It's console logging it to my console. So if you look closely, you will see here, this is a chunk of data. If I look through really well, I will see about four chunks of data that was console logged. So that's one way to do it. So another thing we can do with our chunk is to write the chunk like I've previously explained. So let's quickly do that. So let's write the chunk to a file called writes.txt. So save this, clear up my console. Delete this because I've done this before, so you see what happens. So now I can write my it's console logging because I still have my console log up here. You can decide to comment that out. So this is my file here. So that's pretty simple. That's pretty simple. So yeah, so this is one way to, you know, to use the data or the chunk of data being passed through this stream, through your stream. Another thing you can do is that you can pipe the data. So we use a function or an object called pipe. So you pipe the stream and then you write your data. So let's go back to this diagram. So over here, your pipes, you have your data, your mountain of data or your data, so your mountain of data being passed down in smaller chunks into a buffer. So your buffer stores it up and then sends it through pipe, which then writes the stream to your client or wherever you choose to write the stream to. So yeah, that's just basically what pipes are. So you can only pipe your create read stream. You can only pipe your create read stream. So like I said here, your read stream is being passed down into pipe and then your pipe writes the stream. So that's what is being done here. So let me comment this out right now and then use this method to, you know, write my file. Yeah, so save the file. Let me check if I'm still recording. I'm still recording. Yeah, so clear the file and then, you know, run the code. Let me clear the console up. And then, oh, I have an error. Where is my error from? Data write stream not defined. Okay, so if you remember, I commented my write stream out, so that was a mistake. I wasn't supposed to do that. So yeah, so you can see that Node.js helps us debug codes. So clear this out. So let's do that again. I haven't saved my file, sorry. Save the file with Ctrl S. Alright. So you can see this. So the pipe is just another way of doing the of writing your data. which is really, really fast. You can see how fast it was. That's it for buffers, streams, chunks, pipes. Another thing you can do, you can, you know, have fun with this. If you are watching this video, you can create a server. Create a server and then send whatever data that you have through that server and send it to the client. So I think this was your first task, the task before this file system task, where you were required to create a server and just send files, which most of you did really exceptionally. So this is one way of doing that. So in this one, I decided to create a server and then send down my stream. Comment this out. So yeah, over here I'm creating the stream right in this my server function with this code, passing in my paths and my encoder, and then I'm piping my response. So when I explained the creating or create server class, I told you that your create server takes in two arguments, or it takes in a callback which accepts two arguments, which is your request and your response. And then so with this response, by now you should know what request and response is. So with this response, I am passing that response into my pipe. So over here, you can see over here, we pass in our write stream. Or here, we are passing in our response to data read stream. So if you run this, you should be able to see your file in the browser. So that's it for this video. Before we close, let me just quickly run down through the last class and what I believe was done really well. Most of you really did well with the class, but some of you were creating servers. You were not required to create server in that task. Just get your data from the API with either fetch. So with NodeFetch, this person used NodeFetch here. So you install NodeFetch with npm install NodeFetch. So install that, and then just pass in your URL. So you can see what this guy did here. This guy used create write stream, which was really, really smart. You were not taught create try stream, but he did some research and got this. So he's creating his stream, passing in his paths, and then he's piping it. And that's all. I think there was another one again that I saw that was really, really smart. Yeah, so this is one that was done by some of you or one of you. So he's fetching his data from the API, creating his paths, and then using create write stream, passing down his paths. Over here, he passes his URL from his data, from his API, from the API link. And then he pipes it. That's basically it. A lot of you really did what I wanted. So for just a few of you, overthought the task, and try to do more than yourselves. It's a really, really simple task. You're not really asked to do much, and each requirements carry the points. So yeah, that's basically it for this class. For our next class, I'm thinking of teaching you how to, you know, build a full API node projects from the scratch. So yeah, this is what I have planned for you for the next class. But before that, I might have to explain some certain things. I don't know how we're going to do that. Maybe in the next recording, we'll explain some things before we get to this class. I just ask that you be a little bit patient. The classes are coming. Like I said, we have gotten really, really busy during the course of this program. So you have to understand. It's just part of life. So if you want to learn more about streams and buffers, this is an article you can read, and you know, I might drop this in Slack for you to read. This is one article. This is another article. This article might be a little bit complicated, so this one, I think this one was much more beginner friendly. Yeah, so you can see streams here and buffers. Buffers passed down as chunks, little chunks. So yeah, I will drop this if you want this, so you can read it and, you know, get to learn more about streams. So finally, let me just commend you guys for your patience. Please, you guys should not bother too much about points. The tasks are there for you to do, but the points don't really matter. What matters really is the knowledge you gain from doing those tasks. So if you're not going to do any tasks, of course, you know that you're not going to gain any knowledge. But if you do the task, no matter what you get, no matter the scores awarded to you, the knowledge you gain from doing that task is what matters. So do your tasks, learn more, and push to GitHub, and you know, showcase what you've done. And you will learn as we go. So that will be all for me from this class. See you in the next class.